Now let's look at a question on Francis Tremaine. The question says the following data is given for Francis Tremaine. Net head is 60 meters, RPM is 1700 RPM, shaft power is almost 294 kilowatts, overall efficiency 84%, hydraulic efficiency 93%, flow ratio is 0.2, the ratio of the breadth is 0.1, which is given by small n. The OD of the runner is equal to 2 times the ID. Thickness of vanes occupy 5% of the circumferential area of the runner. Velocity of flow is constant, means VF1 equal to VF2 at inlet and outlet, and discharge is radial at outlet. Find the guide blade angle, the runner vane angles at inlet and outlet, and the dia of runners at inlet and outlet, means D1 and D2. Right, so we need to see that what is this flow ratio and what is this breadth ratio. Right, so flow ratio is given as VF upon 2GH, it is 0.2. From here I can find out VF. So VF is 0.2 into 2 into 9.81. What is the net head? 60 meters. So this becomes 60. So from here, VF becomes 6.86 meters per second. Now, discharge at the outlet is radial, means V2 is equal to VF2 and VW2 is 0. It also says that the velocity of flow is constant at inlet and outlet, means if this is VF1, this would be equal to VF2. Now VF2 is given, means it is equal to V2. Right, so this is equal to V2. Alright, so we've done this part. Now it is also saying that the breadth ratio is 0.1. Now what is this? This is equal to B1 upon D1, this is equal to 0.1. Okay, B is the width and D is the diameter of the inlet, the outlet, sorry. Okay, so now this is the OD. D1 in this case is taken as OD and D2 in this case is taken as ID, because the OD is the inlet and the ID is the outlet. So it's the opposite. Alright, so it says the thickness occupies 0.5% of the circumferential area of the runner, means the actual area is only 0.5% or 0.95%. So you'll have actual area is equal to 0.95 times the circumferential area, that is pi into D1 into B1. Pi into D1 into B1. Alright, so now let's move ahead. We have the overall efficiency. Now what is overall efficiency? Shaft power by water power. So shaft power is 294. From there I can find out the water power. Okay, so you have 0.84 is equal to shaft power 294 by water power. Okay, so water power will be equal to 294.3 upon 0.84. This gives you 350.5 kilowatts. So this is your water power. Now from water power I can find out the discharge. Okay, so water power is equal to rho q g into h upon 1000 kilowatts. Now from here I have the value of water power. We have rho, we have g, we have h. From here we can find out q. So q would be equal to 1000 into 350.5 divided by, you have rho is again 1000, g is 9.81 into 60, that's the net head. So this gives you a value of the discharge as 0.595 meter cube per second. Okay, so this is the discharge. Now from q we can find out the value of d1 and b1, because what is q? Q is equal to area into velocity or flow velocity. So actual area is this. You multiply this actual area by the flow velocity, you get the value for discharge. So from here I can say that Q is equal to 0.95 times pi D1 B1 into VF1. Okay, so that will give you a value for D1 or B1 because you have a relation between B1 and D1. So I can say that B1 is equal to 0.1 times D1. So let's put the value of B1 here in terms of D1. So you will get 0.95 pi into D1 into 0.1 times D1 into VF1. So from here I can get a value for D1 which is 0.54 meters, and this will give you a value of B1 which is 0.054 meters, that is 54 millimeters. So you have the dia at the, or you can say the OD or the inlet of the runner. Okay, so we have got D1, but we need to find out the guide blade angle. How do I do that? Now, because I have D1, I can find out U1 because I also have the RPM. So U1 would be pi into D1 into N1 by 60. Alright, so U1 is pi into D1 0.54 into N is 700 upon 60. This would be in meters per second. So this would be 19.8 meters per second. That is the velocity or the tangential velocity at inlet. So we have U1 over here. Right. So we also have the hydraulic efficiency. Okay. So what is this hydraulic efficiency? Hydraulic efficiency, we have seen the value is VW1 U1 upon G into net head. So from here I can find out VW1, which is a part of the inlet velocity triangle, because eta h is 93%, U1 is 19.8, gravity is known and net head is also known. So I can find out VW1 from there. So this would be 0.93 into 9.81 into 60 upon 19.8. So your VW1 will come out to be 27.66 meters per second. So now we have got VW1. So I have VW1, I have VF1, and why did I want to find out VW1? Because I need to calculate the guide blade angle, which is alpha. So from here I can find out alpha. So alpha is tan inverse of VF1 upon VW1. So VF1 is how much? 6.86, and VW1 is how much? 27.66. So you get tan inverse 6.86 upon 27.66. This would give you 13 degrees, and this would be 56 minutes. So this is the guide blade angle alpha. Okay, so now we have to go to the next part, which is the calculation of the runner vane angles at inlet and outlet, which is theta and phi. Okay, so how do you find that? So if you look at this triangle, you can find out theta. Theta would be tan inverse of VF1 upon VW1 minus U1. Simple as that. So theta is tan inverse of VF1 upon VW1 minus U1. So when you put in the values of VF1, which is 6.86, VW1 is 27.66, and U1 is 19.8, it gives you a value of 41 degrees 5 minutes. Okay, so that is the value of theta, that is the runner vane angle at inlet. Now we need to find this at the outlet. Outlet is phi. For phi, I need tan inverse of VF2 by U2. How do I find U2? For U2, I need the ID. So, but we have the ratio between OD and ID. So I can find out the value of ID in terms of OD, that is half of OD. So U2 would be pi into D2, which is D1 by 2 into N upon 60. So D1 is known to us, D1 is 0.54. So D2 would be 0.27. So I have already done the third part. So D1 is 0.54. That is 540 meters, millimeters, and D2 would be 270 millimeters. That is the ID and OD for the runner. Okay. Now for U2, if you put the value of D1 over here, it would come out to be 9.9896 meters per second. Now we have got U2 over here. Now we can use the OVT to calculate phi. So phi would be tan inverse of VF2 upon U2. So you will get tan inverse of VF2 is how much? 6.86 by U2 is 9.896. Okay, so for your phi would come out to be 34 degree 44 minutes. So that is the vane angle at outlet for the runner. So I hope you got this. This is a very lengthy calculation intensive question. So make sure you understand the IVT and the OVT in detail. So I hope you got this. Now let's move on to one more question on Francis Levine.